Shalom Israel, this is Bishop Nathaniel. The Israelites have been scattered across the four corners of the earth, as prophesied in Deuteronomy, the 20th chapter. Here at Israel United in Christ, we need your help to recover the remnant of our people, teach them the gospel. Please help us, support us, and join or donate to the Booster Club today. Shalom.
We are here once again with another hot topic. We got Officer Yedai in the building, ready to edify the people on a heavy topic today, and tis the season for this topic. This topic will be Masters Holidays, exposing Masters Holidays. So I want y'all to tune in, get your notebooks, get your Bible, because everything is by the Word of God, it's by the Scriptures. So do not get mad at any opinions. Take it up with the Most High God. So again, we got Officer Dothan in the building, and we got Officer Uriah in the building with us. And we're going to be bringing in a heavy topic today for all y'all who don't know. So with that being said, I'm going to turn the show over to Officer Yedai. And we are Israel United in Christ, letting the blacks, so-called blacks, Native Americans, and Hispanics know that you are the true Israelites according to the Bible.
All right, all praise to the Most High. All praise to the Most High. So you said, tis the season.
Tis the season.
Tis the season. Tis the season for what exactly?
Right.
Is it the season to be merry?
Right.
Don't say it's the season to be jolly.
Yeah, jolly. We don't even use that word beside this year. Tis the season.
Tis the season.
Jolly.
To be jolly. The word jolly means happiness. Y'all know that, right?
Yes, sir.
So yeah. They say this is the season is a time period, right?
Right.
So this is the time period to be happy, right? But the question is, what do we as a people have to be happy about or joyous about? What do we have to be merry about?
Working, spending all our money, and spending it on somebody else so we could be in debt. That's a joyful occasion. Debt is great.
So my question is, why is Christmas so near and dear to the black man's heart? Why is that? Why is America's holidays sear in our brains? Why are we a part of America's culture in their holidays? Why?
We get the day off.
We get the day of PTO. A little bit of PTO goes a long way. You know what I mean? So you gotta ask yourself, you know, did we know about Christmas before we got here? Thanksgiving, Easter, 4th of July. Did we know about any of those things before we got off of them ships? That's the question. So let's get Deuteronomy 28. Let's get Deuteronomy 28, 15. Nobody ever sit back and ask the question, what do these things have to do with us?
Right.
What do these have to do with us? Nobody ever asked that. So let's get Deuteronomy 28.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 15. Mm-hmm. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord, thy God, mm-hmm. to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, mm-hmm. that all these curses shall come upon thee.
So first and foremost, right? We are on the show today to edify our people. Who are our people? I'm gonna state it again. You so-called blacks, Hispanics, Native American Indians, you are the biblical Israelites that the Bible speaks of.
That's
yes,
right.
The Bible deals with a people, all right? So God told that people, who are our ancestors, if we don't keep his commandments, curses will come upon us and overtake us. He was not talking to everybody. That's pretty. He was not talking to everybody. You know what I want? Deuteronomy 1. We'll go to Deuteronomy chapter 1. God was not talking to everybody. All right? Let's read that. Let's see who he's talking to.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 1, verse 1. These be the words which Moses spake unto all Israel.
Unto the whole world.
Unto all Israel.
So we are listening to the words that God spoke to all Israel. God talked to Moses. Moses spoke to our forefathers. That was the complete audience, all right? So he told us, go back to what we just said. I want y'all to listen very, very closely. You know, read verse 15. Let's find out who got cursed and why.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 15. Mm-hmm. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So Moses is talking to the nation of Israel. He said, all these curses will come upon thee. That thee is us.
That's right.
We are the us. Get that in Amos 3. He said, these curses come upon thee and overtake thee. That thee is the us. All right? Let's get Amos chapter 3 and verse 1.
This is the book of Amos chapter 3. Verse 1.
I'm just trying to show y'all how specific this Bible is. I know how people say pacific. This Bible is very, very pacific. It's talking directly to us. Read that.
You said pacific.
This Bible is specific. It's talking specifically to us. I ain't to my dog.
That's right. Amos chapter 3, verse 1. Hear this word that the Lord hath spoken against you, O children of Israel.
You see that thing says, O you. That you is us. Once again, children of Israel. Come on.
Against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. Mm-hmm. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
Y'all see the thing? So the Most High God, he deals with a particular family. God is not dealing with everybody. All right? God deals with a particular family. He says, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. When the last time we heard that at church?
Never.
One last time Big Mama read that to us before we went to bed.
Never.
You know, I heard that in the lion's den, Shadrach, Meshach.
And Abednego.
Abednego. It's time for you to go to bed. Go.
Right.
But I never ever heard that before. Read that thing one more time, bro. I people need to hear this thing.
Amos chapter 3, verse 1. Mm-hmm. Hear this word that the Lord have spoken against you, O children of Israel, mm-hmm. against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth. Mm-hmm. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
So God says, if we did not keep his commandments, he will punish us for our iniquities. I'm going to tell y'all right now, I'm going to give you a spoiler alert. You keeping Christmas is a punishment. You keeping right. Thanksgiving is a punishment.
That's right.
You keeping 4th of July is a punishment.
It's a punishment?
It's a punishment. I'm going to prove it. Get to Deuteronomy 28. Because we're about to read a curse. It's not a blessing. We're about to read a curse. Deuteronomy 28 and verse 48. You keeping Easter morning Sunday? That's a curse. I'm telling you right now. These are all master's holidays. So let's read about how you got these things. Deuteronomy 28, 48.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 48. Therefore, shalt thou serve thine enemies.
Listen, we don't like working for a check, let alone working for free, all right? The Bible says God told we would serve our enemies. Read.
Which the Lord shall send against thee mm-hmm. in hunger.
So we got to go to them when we get home. We go to what? Walmart. We get our food. We fill the whole cart up. Got GMOs in it. Vegetables ain't got no seeds in them. Fruits ain't got no seeds in them. Do vegetables even got seeds?
No more.
Did they ever have seeds? I don't know.
I know, but bananas had seeds in them, and I never seen a seed in a banana.
Man, you only got seeds in grapes no more.
Right.
I thought seedless grapes was a luxury.
Right.
How far have we fallen? Read that verse again, bro. Verse 48.
Verse 48. Mm-hmm. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 48. Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies, which the Lord shall send against thee mm-hmm. in hunger.
We gotta go to them in hunger now. Read.
And in thirst.
When we get thirsty, we gotta go to them now. When we get our Kool-Aid, when we get our Aquafina, our Fiji, we want to the master. He get paid after that. Read on.
And in nakedness.
When we get dressed. Guess what? The same person that owns Louis Vuitton, he owns Hennessy. Hmm. The company is called Hennessy Louis Vuitton.
Interesting.
So in hunger and in thirst. And they smile, anything is possible. Like, that's a black drink. That's not no black drink.
Right.
If that's black, then Kool-Aid is black. Just because we're the main consumers does not mean that we are the producers.
Right.
Exactly. So it says, in hunger and in thirst, read on.
And in nakedness.
And in nakedness, read.
And in want of all things.
No. In want of some things.
In all things.
No, we go to them for a couple of things, but we still keep some things that we had with us before the slave ship.
In want of all things.
That includes your Christmas. That includes your Thanksgiving. God didn't leave anything, God, he says, and in want of all things. In want of all things, read on.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck mm-hmm. until he have destroyed thee.
So you gotta let that thing marinate. We go to our enemies and want of all things. Now ask yourself, were we cutting down trees in the coast of West Africa? Actually, was we doing that?
Fir trees at that.
Pine, what they call? A partridge and a pine tree?
Evergreens.
Was we sending red hearts with chocolate in them and the shows of what was we doing that? Was we keeping Valentine's? What were we doing? You gotta ask yourself these things. God said we would go to them in one of all things. So with that being said, we as a people, as a majority, we have never learned to really ask questions. We are not curious as a people at all. So real quick, give me go to that quote about questions. I saw a heavy quote about questions. We gotta read that thing. That thing is heavy, man. We as a people, we have not learned. We don't care to ask questions about anything that we do. I ain't gonna deal with the elephant in the room like, what's your nationality? I ain't dealing with that. What's your nationality? We ask them about their nationality, they start doing math. They be like, carry the one. My daddy called himself black. Granddaddy said he's an Asiatic black man. My sister, she says she's a Negro.
Right.
My grandma's a colored woman.
I'm mixed. I'm everything.
You sound like a third degree poodle. You know, I got 10% Asian in me, 17% Cocker Spaniel. Like, what are you talking about?
Who are you?
You ask a basic question, what's your nationality? You get no answer.
Some people get offended.
Yeah.
I don't want to talk about that.
What did you do with that? I'm Muslim.
Yeah. Bro, I'm Christian.
Brother, those are religions. I'm asking you about your nationality.
I'm Christian. And they say it with confidence, too.
To my, I'm Baptist. I didn't ask what your denomination was.
Right.
So we can't even deal with basic things like, who are we? Let me study that. Let me research. We don't even deal with that. So right now, we're just going to deal with these holidays that we keep, for example. So first of all, give me that quote on questions, off.
Questioning is the ability to organize our thinking around what we do not know.
You gotta read that thing slow, five people, bro.
Questioning is the ability to organize our thinking around what we don't know.
Questioning is the ability to organize your thinking around finding out what you do not know. When have we ever asked, what does a fat man with a knapsack have to do with Jesus Christ?
Right.
When have we ever asked, how can I be two continents? African American. How can I be two and guess what? America, that's three continents, because which America?
North, South?
Am I African North America or am I African South America?
Right.
Am I African Latin America? What am I? Am I three continents?
People go. The biggest continents together.
That's what I'm saying.
Two biggest in the world and we just take it.
Well, no question. Questioning is the ability to organize your thinking about what you don't know. What am I? Am I African, South America? What am I? Just basic things, you know. So, as smart as we are, we have never organized our mind to ask some important questions. You know, give me Psalms 82 and 5. I want to bring something out real quick. Psalms 82 and 5.
Even the ones that say they wise and the deep people, you got all these people leading movements but can't get to the simple basics.
Color?
Negroes, Muslims, and Christians all are on one accord to get where? When nobody has the same goal.
What's that quote about a million man? You know what I'm talking about? It's
the
a quote.
Lurch.
Yeah, it's a quote behind that. Somebody had made a quote. Something about
it turned into the million man block party.
Dang.
Something like that.
Dang, I ain't talking about that. It turned into the million man block party after you're done talking, huh?
I know Bishop brought up something that was heavy on that thing. But.
Yeah, I think they said you can get a million man walking in a million different directions is not power.
Right.
But if you can get men to walk in the same direction, now that's power. Right. It's something like that. But you got a million men with a million different beliefs.
Mm-hmm. And then what happened to it after that? It just become a trend. Like you said, it's a block party. After that, what production have they got done? No results out of none of the million man marches. Not one result that changed anything. Million men get together for nothing.
Hmm. So real quick, get Psalms 82 and 5. Watch this. Psalms 82 and 5. A lot of people don't ask basic questions. You know, we got some bags of people and we gotta acknowledge that. Like, dang, I don't ask questions. You sit in church every Sunday. When's the last time you ask them, prove what you're saying? You telling me that I have to reap a seed to get up? Show me that in the Bible. Just show me that thing in the Bible.
Pay your tithes, pray about it. Jesus will show you.
He's my, will a man rob God? Can you give me more clarity on that?
Right.
After service, can we sit down? Let me look at your notes. You always put your hand in the way. I want to see your notes.
Talk to my assistant. I'll see you next month. I'm busy.
That's heavy, man. Get Psalms 82 and 5.
This is the book of Psalms, chapter 82, verse 5.
Uh-huh.
They know not, Mm-hmm. Neither will they understand.
So our people don't know, and it says neither will they understand. Go ahead.
They walk on in darkness. Mm-hmm. All the foundations of the earth are out of course.
It said what?
All the foundations of the earth are out of course.
While our people are asleep, not knowing nationality, not knowing our homeland is the land of Israel, not knowing God is our Father and we are His chosen, it says everything else in the earth is out of order. Mm. If the black man is not on top, the whole earth is out of order. How can we be the greatest people mentally, inventors, athletically, everything you can think of, but we at the bottom? Mm. That is out of order. Mm. That's topsy-turvy. You understand? Us keeping Thanksgiving? The Bible says everything is out of course, right?
Right.
Of course, that's like a track. That's an order.
Right.
Y'all gonna make this left, and then y'all gonna make this other left, and y'all gonna make this other left. You know,
right.
That's a plan. That's order to it. You understand? They don't make right turns in NASCAR.
Right.
You understand? So when God said everything is out of course, that means everything is out of order.
Right.
We not on track right now. You got birds flying north for the winter, flying south for the summer. No, they supposed to, you know, everything is out of order because we out of order. Us right. keeping Thanksgiving, that's out of course.
Right.
Us keeping 4th of July. July 4th. Where were you?
Right.
You know I say September 11th? Where were you? Everybody, I know where I was at. Okay, well, what was your people at July 4th, 1776? Hmm. Let's think about it. Anybody got the car facts?
Quick thought. That's a quick thought. Sis, where was we at 1776?
July 4th. What was we at?
Something to talk about at the barbecue. What y'all say?
Hmm. Where was black people at in 1776?
Were we popping fireworks?
No.
Were we shaking sparklers? Roman candles? What was we doing, sis?
We were on the front line.
We were on the front line?
Yeah.
Give me a simple word for that.
We were at war. We were fighting the white man's war. We were fighting a British war, to be exact.
There you go. We was fighting, but everybody...
AKA the Revolutionary War.
Okay, but was all of us
fighting? No.
Who revolution was it?
It was the white man's revolution, even though they had us on the front line. Mm-hmm. Big facts.
And when they were not going to war prior to Great Britain, between 1619 and 1776, mm-hmm. what were we doing, sis?
Picking cotton.
Between 1776 and 1865, mm-hmm. what were we doing, sis?
Picking cotton.
Right. Exactly.
So, so tell me why the Negro, why the Hispanic, the Latin man and woman, why are we keeping 4th of July?
Right. Because you know, nowadays for them it's just a dance celebration. Nobody recognizes it unless they're, you know, a veteran white man. Nobody really recognizes it for what they, you know, took it to be in the beginning. You know, I don't think anybody takes the holiday seriously anymore, you know.
Mm-hmm. But July 4th is AKA Independence Day.
Their Independence Day. It was never
ours. You said you standing correctly now? You said mm-hmm. their Independence mm-hmm. Day. You said that thing?
Big facts.
Man, if it's their Independence Day, we got no business having a barbecue.
Period. Mm-hmm.
You said that thing? Mm-hmm. It's masses. It has nothing to do with us. You know what's heavy? You just said it was the Revolutionary War against Britain, right?
Right.
Okay. They was fighting against Britain, right? They was mm-hmm. fighting against oppression mm-hmm. of their own people. Meanwhile, back at the plantation,
was it oppression of their own people? See,
Great Britain was taxing them.
Yeah, but you okay.
That's not slavery though.
Thank you. That's all I'm saying.
You know, I ain't
that's
going nuts. No, we hold no punches.
Okay.
They weren't cracking no whips on each other.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
They mad because they put an extra penny on sugar.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. Right.
Tis I've had this is the straw that has broken the camel's back.
This is preposterous.
You gonna throw tea over the boat?
Oh, they proposed a new tea tax. No, so it wasn't even the same thing. But even that, they couldn't even deal with that. They couldn't take it. I've had it. Let's go to war.
Right.
So, what are we doing celebrating 4th of July? Singing, my country, tis of thee.
Right.
Sweet right. land of liberty.
And you know what's crazy? Blacks is the biggest consumer on fireworks that day.
You gotta be crazy.
The biggest consumers on fireworks.
You gotta be crazy.
Oh man, the block wasn't popping unless the big man on the block had the biggest fireworks.
You ain't lying about
that. You already know
where the streets will be shut down. Yes. The street will be shut down. Everybody in the neighborhood come out their house to see the big man on the block fire off his fireworks.
Yeah, yeah.
He probably spent like $3,000 to $5,000 on fireworks.
Big Rocket take Little Rocket. It was just it became a hood competition.
It is.
We knew exactly where we didn't go see the city fireworks. We went to the hood to go where who was making the most money. You gonna know how the biggest fireworks show.
Right.
Our people is shot out for that thing.
Go to the neighborhood where the so-called neighborhood dope man stay.
Oh yeah.
And everybody flood to that part of the neighborhood just to see his fireworks display.
Lighting it right next to them 24 rims. You see the rim in the background where you light it. They put it on YouTube. It becomes a thing.
Dang.
Our people love that thing.
Yeah, but you still got that cool Negro living in the burbs who was going downtown.
Definitely.
Had the national anthem going off.
With the red, white, and blue outfit, the flag outfit.
Yeah, got the flag shorts on, the slip trunks.
The stars on the shirt and the striped shorts.
standing up with the hat over his heart, like a runaway slave caught going the wrong way. Where you going, what, master? I just sing the national anthem, boss. I just gonna sing this thing.
Probably.
You know I was too stupid trying to run away, boss. But nowadays, man. You know, you downtown with your red, white, and blue outfit on. You got the striped ones, you know. But give me on that topic. Give me Psalms 137.
My country, tears rolling down brother's eyes.
Oh my God,
man. Sister's eyes when the song come on.
It's like and the rockets wreck. Brother get goosebumps.
Yeah.
Let's get what David said.
Yet and still, the veteran with the tears rolling down his eyes, yet and still, he can't even get his veteran's check.
He said, when on his prosthetic leg.
Right.
Get Psalms 137. Let's see what David said. Read that. Verse 3.
Psalms chapter 137, verse 3.
Uh-huh.
For there they that carried us away captive.
We forgot that we would carry him captive. And then he had the nerve to be happy about people who got independence and liberty when we didn't have independence or liberty. We were very much so captive and very much so dependent.
Right.
Read on.
Required of us a song.
They what?
Required of us a song.
Why do you always want to get up to sing the national anthem on the 4th of July anyway?
Soul to the earth.
Why is it always, so, yeah, you're right about that thing.
It ain't gonna be appreciated unless one of our sisters or brothers out there singing it.
They said, well, somebody gotta sing. Yeah, he don't have to sing it right.
Right.
And they know we always forget the end, too. No, but
sleep about their own slavery.
Read 3 again.
Psalms 137, verse 3. Mm-hmm. For there they that carried us away captive required of us a song.
The same people who kidnapped us, the Bible says. Remember, we're reading your Bible, the same one you got at home right now. You might want to open it up.
Right.
The same people who carried us away captive, they want us to sing. Who is that besides the black man, black woman? Who is this people? It says, they're there that cares for capital required of us a song. Read on.
And they that wasted us required of us mirth.
They that wasted us took from us everything. If you waste your water, you don't have no more water.
Mm-hmm.
Those that took everything from us to the point we don't have anything required of us mirth, joy. Read on.
Sing. Sing us one of those songs.
Sing
of Zion. Sing us one of those songs of Zion.
Sing, boy. Sing. Damn.
You did real good, girl. Sing us one of those songs. But what's the spirit of our righteous forefathers in their right mind? Read the reply to what the heathen say.
Verse 4.
Huh?
How shall we sing the
How
Lord?
Shall what?
How shall we sing the
How Lord? How we gonna sing my country tears of thee, but every couple of years y'all gotta vote whether I'm able to vote.
Right.
Then they did have a big sense. You remember that? Wait, was that last year? They just deliberated whether we can vote again or not?
That was this year, I believe.
That was this year, wasn't it?
Mm. Mm-hmm. No, it wasn't this year.
I think it was last year.
Last year.
They just came together like, is a Negro going to be able to vote? You know, if I'm a citizen, like you say I am, then I have the rights that you can't take from me. But they don't want to admit that we're not citizens.
Right. We still 3/5 of a man.
Exactly. So they don't want to admit that we're not citizens because it's too sensitive. So instead of them doing that, they just do what? They just they come together and say, you know what, we're going to decide whether you're able to vote again.
And don't let the vote matter, though.
Yeah, Dred Scott case.
Yeah, these are Negro votes. These are people that we'll just make an electoral vote. Only people with a couple million left is really mattering. Mm-hmm. Everybody crying to make it vote pins. Everybody got a pin on, and they already got your votes categorized in a box to mean nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Not even considered human.
Exactly. The Supreme Court ruled, remember that, against Dred Scott?
Mm-hmm.
The Negro has no rights by which the white man was bound to respect.
Yeah.
Come on, man. Read off of us. Our forefathers, the spirit in their right mind, we're not singing for no heathens. We in captivity. They got us over here with no receipt. This is called captivity. They right. shoplift us. They came over there, they took us across the water. This is federal shoplifting. Hmm. You understand? And now they want us to sing for them.
Human trafficking.
Exactly. Come on, read that.
Verse 4. How shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange land?
It says, how shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange... So that's for all you brothers out there, all you sisters out there singing the national anthem. This is not your nation.
That's right.
It has nothing to do with you.
Yeah. They still play Whitney Houston national anthem on repeat. It's probably about 40 million views on YouTube about her singing the national anthem. Sing, nigga, sing. Mm. Man.
Dang. So we got no business celebrating July 4th whatsoever. But you know what's heavy? Since you know it's getting cold, right? Y'all know what's another huge thing? Our people be gathering in large numbers downtown again and other places to watch a ball drop.
Right.
We gather at 11:59 to watch a ball drop. That's just a heavy thing. First of all, New Year's, right? New Year's. How, Sway?
How?
In the winter, Sway.
When everything dead.
Everything is dead. What is new? What is new on December 31st? Jane, what is new?
The outfit is Jake buying to go down there to watch the ball. It's the only thing new. So, buy new shoes to go watch a ball drop.
So, officer, you mean to... So, Adam and Eve in the garden in the winter. Can you even have a winter garden?
Eating fruit.
Supposedly, right? Supposedly eating fruit. You got a garden in the winter. A garden.
Right.
In the winter, isn't it just dirt? It don't say Adam and Eve was in the dirt pile, do it?
Not at all.
The frosty mud, is that what it says in the scriptures? I could have sworn he placed them in the Garden of Eden. Which they say the new year is in the time period where everything is dead. Well, let's deal with that. Let's get, first of all, let's get Genesis 1. Because they say the day starts at what, midnight, right? 12 o'clock a.m. Let's see if that's what God said.
This is the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 14.
Verse 5.
Verse 5.
Let's see when the day starts and ends, according to God. Who our people believe in. Our people have a zeal for God. You know, we say we want to please him. Okay, so, Lord's will, y'all get edified. Let's find out when the day starts and ends. Let's see, is it at 12 a.m.?
This is the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 5. Mm-hmm. And God called the light day,
uh-huh.
and the darkness he called night. Mm-hmm. And the evening.
And the what?
And the evening.
The evening is when the sun goes down. We're not talking about when you got the beautiful horizon with the orange and the yellow and the red and all the different colors. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about when all those colors are gone and you can't see the sun, that is the evening. Right about this time of the year, the sun is going about 6 p.m. About 6 p.m. the sun is gone. What y'all say? About 6 p.m.?
Yeah, about 6 now.
Right, so that's the evening. So that's when the new day begins according to the Bible. That's why even in their wiki holidays, even the white man's holidays, he says what? New Year's, the day before that's called what?
New Year's Eve.
New Year's Eve, that's the night before, because he knew it started when the sun went down the day before. Before Christmas, you have what? Christmas Eve. You understand?
You're in the spirit,
huh? It's the night before. You see that thing?
Mind if I read this for him real quick, the highlighted part for off.
Let's bring it out.
This is from the book, The Pagan Book of Days.
Who's it by?
Nigel Pennick. In ancient Greece, for example, the day was reckoned to run from dawn until the following dawn. The day in the Central and Northern European tradition begins at sunset, as it does in the Jewish tradition.
Hold on. Read that last part again.
The day in Central and Northern European tradition begins at sunset, as it does in the Jewish tradition. Symbolically and literally, this day starts in darkness and continues through the next period of daylight until the following sunset.
You see that thing? So our forefathers reckoned the day the way God told us the day was reckoned, from evening to evening.
Mm-hmm.
Not wait till midnight, and even that is called the middle of the night.
Right.
It's not the beginning of anything.
Right.
It don't say 12 a.m. is not called the beginning of the day. It's called midnight. It's the middle of the night. It's not the beginning of anything.
That's crazy.
It makes no sense.
Threw poop right in their face and they don't smell it, man. just walking around with poop on their face. Finish that out for us.
This is why all of the customary festivals of the year are preceded by an eve or afton, taken as being the night before. Even in secular usage, they are still common. New Year's Eve, May Eve, All Hallows Eve, and Christmas Eve, to name but a few. Sometimes, however, the word Eve is applied erroneously to the whole calendar day.
So erroneously means what? In ignorance.
You say Christmas Eve, you can open your presents.
Exactly.
They always let you open that first present at Christmas Eve because, and subconsciously, it was already celebrated. That's when the day start. Although the Bible made it plain, our people would deny that just because Master says so.
Exactly. Read Genesis 1 and 5 again.
This is the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 5. And God called the light day, and the darkness he called night.
Right.
And the evening and the morning were the first day.
It says the evening and then the morning. The day does not start in the middle of the night. It starts hours before midnight. In the summer, it may start a little closer to midnight. Sometimes the sun is out in the summer to 9:30, things of that nature. But whenever the sun is completely down, in the summertime about 9:30, that's when the day begins. And it's reckoned until the sun is all the way down the next day. That's a complete day. All
right.
Typically 24-hour period, all right? So, Adam and Eve, back to them again. There is no way a loving God, don't people say God is love? Don't you hear that in the Christian church?
Mm-hmm.
God is love, baby.
God is love.
God is love, baby. Why would a loving God put Adam and Eve, why would he make them in the middle of the winter? Don't they call winter the mean season?
Yep. Right.
Don't they call it the mean season?
Yeah.
That hawk? So why would God put them in a place where everything is dead and say, he made life and then put them in a time period where everything was dead. It makes no sense at all.
And let there be life when everything's dead.
Exactly.
Man. Yeah.
So let's find out when the new year actually is, because obviously it's not when the white man says it is. So let's get Exodus 12.
Right.
Let's find out the real new year.
Bring it out.
This is the book of Exodus, chapter 12, verse 1. Mm-hmm. And the Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, saying, this month shall be unto you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year to you.
So guess what? God gave us a calendar. God gave our people a calendar. And guess what the calendar did not start with? It didn't start with winter. So let's find out when it started. Get Deuteronomy 16 now.
So it ain't January 1st?
It ain't January 1st. It ain't December 31st. Let's get Deuteronomy 16. That's a cruel God to put his chosen Adam in a freezing winter. In a freezing winter. Like, yeah, start naming these animals.
Right.
in the mean season.
He's shivering. I'm going to call you sheep. It don't make no sense.
Half of the animals is hibernated.
Exactly. What did he name the grizzly bear? Even the grizzly got sense to hide.
I know I see something big out here. I got to wait for it to come. What?
Bro, don't like
name
seals.
Later.
Don't like seals and stuff get stuck under the ice. It don't make no sense at all.
You got to name all types of water animals in the mean season?
I'm going to name them later. I'll wait. Eve will wait. She wasn't even there yet.
Man, you're going too happy for him, bro.
Yeah. Keep it simple.
Yeah, you're going to be succeeding. So, remember, we just left Exodus. It shows that what? God does care about the calendar. He said, look, this month should be the first month. What month was that? Deuteronomy 16, I see what was the name of that month. Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 16, verse 1. Mm-hmm. Observe the month of Abib.
So this is explaining what you was reading in Exodus. The first five books, they kind of overlap, and one explains more things in detail. So now we're going to Deuteronomy 16. This is a precept. So it says this month of what?
Observe the month of Abib.
It says observe the month of Abib. Off, can you get the definition of Abib? He says observe the month of Abib. Finish up.
And keep the Passover unto the Lord thy God.
Read on.
For in the month of Abib, the Lord thy God brought thee forth out of the land, out of Egypt by night.
Right.
Excuse me.
So go ahead.
This is the definition of Abib out of Merriam-Webster Dictionary.
Mm-hmm.
Abib, the first month of the ancient Hebrew calendar corresponding to Nisan.
Uh-huh. Go ahead. I'm going to use a literal meaning.
Okay, excuse me. Abib, literally, ear of grain.
It says the word Abib literally translates to ear of grain. When do ears of grain begin to sprout? When, what time period is that?
Spring.
In the spring. In the spring, not in the winter. Everything is dead in the winter. January is not the first month. Yes, we've been duped again. They gave us the wrong nationality, but you thought they were going to give us the right seasons?
Right.
The right months? No.
Just don't stop there.
It don't stop. The can't stop, won't stop. Bad Boy Records.
The whole world is out of
take
course.
Take that.
Now, look. Go ahead. Go back to the bit. Start from the top.
Deuteronomy chapter 6.
Merriam-Webster, go ahead.
Definition of Abib. Mm-hmm. The first month of the ancient Hebrew calendar.
It says the first month of the ancient Hebrew calendar. And then read what it literally means again. Why was it called that? Why is that the first month?
Abib, literally, ear of grain.
So what Abib means, it means ear of grain. Things start to, life begins in the spring.
Right.
That's when they were placed in the garden, in the spring. Why? When life starts to begin. Remember, God said, let there be light. He started to create. In the beginning, God created. Not God destroyed everything.
Right.
Which is literally how it looks in the wintertime. Like somebody came through and destroyed everything.
Right.
You look at a tree like, is that the same tree? Yeah, that's how it looked when that frost comes through here.
Right, when those flowers ain't blooming.
Yes, give me Numbers 9 real quick. Numbers 9, verse 1.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 9, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord spake unto Moses in the wilderness of Sinai.
Mm-hmm.
In the first month.
When?
In the first month of the second year after they were come out of the land of Egypt, saying,
mm-hmm.
Let the children of Israel also keep the Passover.
When?
At his appointed season.
The Passover, you will always find, is in the spring.
Yep.
You can look at any calendar. The Passover is always in the spring. God says that's the first month. So if the white man knows when the Passover is, then he knows when the year starts. But he's not going to tell you that. He will not tell you that. Why? Because he want to keep you in sin. He want to keep you observing his holidays. He want to keep you worshiping his gods.
Right.
What do people do on New Year's anyway when the ball drops? What do? They make what?
They get
resolution.
You see that thing?
Oh yeah.
Make that resolution.
And what else they do? You about to say it.
They get drunk.
What is, besides the New Year's resolution, what is it associated with? It's associated with partying. Reveling.
Reveling.
Exactly.
That's what it's associated with. What else is it associated with?
Fornication.
I'm about to.
True indeed.
I'm about to watch this ball drop. Lie, because nobody keeps a resolution. I'm about to watch this ball drop.
Lie.
And go lie with a woman.
Then lie with a woman.
In that order. Domino effect. You know.
Real quick, the same book that highlighted part. Just to show how much our people is into paganism, and they don't realize nothing they're doing is according to God. They're in the midst of paganism. Off just said something heavy. The month that they do New Year's in is in January. And what they do? Revel and lie. But watch where they get the lie from. Read that.
Reading out of the pagan book of days. January. January is sacred to the Roman god Janus.
To who?
To the Roman god Janus.
Uh-huh.
The two-faced divinity of endings and beginnings.
So this is a Roman god. Our people know that they say they love Jesus, but what they don't know is they're in the midst of paganism, worshiping Janus. Read.
Janus is the male equivalent of one of the versions of the goddess Juno Janus, who, in her two-faced aspects of Antivora and Pas Travorta, looks simultaneously forward and backward, as does Janus.
This is where we get our New Year's resolution. Watch how heavy this gets. Read.
January marks the beginning of the new year, yet contains elements of that which went before. Its quality is thus one of new possibilities, but constrained by that which took place in the old year before it.
So like I said, New Year's resolution, it's a possibility, but they never hold that thing. What is we in the midst of? paganism, worshiping Janus. The god looked two ways because it looked at his past and it looks to the future. And now that same spirit got the mind frame of all of our people. We still doing the same thing they did in ancient Rome. Babylonian to Rome is paganism. This is what the officer is bringing out. We are in the midst of paganism, but yet everybody loved Jesus.
Ain't got nothing to do with Jesus. And back to that New Year's resolution. Give me 1 Samuel real quick. Back to that resolution. I got to touch on that thing. I want to make a New Year's resolution. Yeah, right. Get 1 Samuel 2. And act like you just made an oath. Who you making your oath to? Because that ain't God New Year.
Right.
And Janus ain't got nothing to do with the Most High or his son Christ.
Exactly.
So who is this resolution or this oath to? Read that. 1 Samuel 2 and verse 3.
1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 2.
This is what God got to say about your New Year's resolution. Go ahead.
There is none holy as...
1 Samuel 2.
1 Samuel 2, verse 2, right?
Verse 3.
Verse 3.
Uh-huh.
Talk no more so exceeding proudly.
You're going to sit back in the beginning of your 12-month period, because it definitely ain't the New Year, and you're going to say what you're going to do for the next 12 months. But you don't remember what you did last Wednesday.
Right.
But you want to sit up and say what you're going to do for the next 12 months. Read what God said again, bro, please.
This is for the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 2, verse 3.
Come on.
Talk no more so exceeding proudly.
What did it say?
Talk no more so exceeding proudly.
Read it.
Let not arrogancy come out of your mouth.
Who is you that can't remember what you did last Wednesday to say what you're going to do for the next 12 months? Who are you? God's talking about so exceedingly proudly. Read on.
For the Lord is a God of knowledge,
uh-huh,
and by him actions are weighed.
How many people even follow through with them resolutions that they proclaim on that day? How many people follow through?
Whole Foods at a high, high. Everybody vegan on New Year's. New Year's, January 2nd, everybody vegan.
Everybody vegan.
For 20 days.
No, for 2 hours.
Two, yeah.
Tomorrow. What, a PB&J that ain't vegan? No. The bread got eggs in it. Oh, man.
True.
Well, I'm a vegetarian.
Until they don't see how much a loaf of bread costs, yeah, I'm a vegetarian. That thing expensive.
Man. So most of God say actions are way. Give me Sirach on that same topic. Give me Sirach 4. Make my New Year's resolution.
What we showing y'all is you're in the midst of paganism, people. You worshiping your oppressors when they had us in slavery, 4th of July, and now you see you in the midst of worshiping Janus on the deadest month of the year.
A two-headed God, one head face forward, one head face backwards. That's why at the end of the year, you look at the beginning of the year. That's in reverence of the two-headed God.
Double-minded man.
Wow.
Janus. I knew a sister named Jan. She was two-faced.
Dang. Dang. Hey, Janus, but we love you, sis, and you can repent.
Right.
All praise to the Most High.
Right. Get rid of Canada.
Praise
to the Most High.
Yeah. This is Sirach 4.
Shout out to Canada.
All praises. Sirach
4:29. Sirach chapter 4, verse 29.
Mm-hmm.
Be not hasty in thy tongue.
Be what?
Be not hasty in thy tongue.
It says, be not hasty in your tongue. Don't be, first of all, you're worshiping a fake God. One. Number two, that ain't the New Year. Number three, God said what?
Be not hasty in thy tongue.
Don't ever think you can proclaim what's going to happen for the next 12 months. It says don't be hasty in your tongue. Read on.
And in thy deeds slack and remiss.
Well, you ain't going to do nothing. It says in your deeds you slack and remiss. Meaning what? You lazy and there is no follow through amongst our people.
Right.
You know what, bro? I'm going to go to the gym every day. I'm about to stop eating this.
Right.
I'm about to get ready to put some
medication. I'm about to put 2 miles on the treadmill every day.
I'm about to be faithful to my wife. I'm about to eat.
Right.
Brother, you ain't finna do nothing.
Right.
You ain't about to do nothing.
Right.
Stop being hasty in your tongue and your deeds, slack and remiss. New Year's resolutions is trash, and that ain't the New Year, Negro. Right. From there. Give me Daniel 7:25. I can't forget that thing. I almost let that thing slip. Because God told us that this will happen.
Yeah, bring it out.
So-called white man put us in slavery. God told us what was going to happen. Daniel 7, verse 25.
This is the book of Daniel, chapter 7, verse 25.
Mm.
And he shall speak great words against the Most High.
It says that the so-called white man, that's what this verse is talking about. What he would do when he had us under his rulership. He would speak great words against the Most High. What are some great words? He says, there is no God. In the beginning, there was some type of crash between molecules and particles, and somehow all that chaos made order.
Right.
And the sun is out for 12 hours, and the moon is out for 12 hours, and the earth is on a cycle, and the moon is on a, does different phases and repeats those same exact, all this order came from chaos.
Right. Mm. No way possible.
No way possible, but that's them great words that he spoke against the Most High. Like, look at all this beauty in the world. No one did it. There was a big bang.
It was a big bang.
But no one was holding a gun. When have you heard a big sound and nobody was the culprit? But it says he would speak great words against the Most High. Go ahead.
And shall wear out the saints of the Most High.
And he wore our behinds out in slavery. He's wearing us out to this day. Same when your parents wore your behind out, the white man wearing us out. It says he would speak great words against our father and wear out the saints of the Most High. Who are the saints of the Most High? You blacks and Hispanics. Go ahead.
The saints of the Most High, and think to change times.
Whoa. Yeah, read that slow. Yeah. He shall do what else?
And think to change times.
He done taught God's people that the new year is when everything is dead. Hmm. When everything look old. That don't make no sense. It says he shall think to change times. It says think to change times. Why? Because the remnant of us was going to come back to the truth. Mm-hmm. We celebrate our new year when? The same month we celebrate the Passover.
That's right.
Because the month of the Passover, that's the month of the new year. It's in the spring. So it says he would think to change times. Why? Because the majority of our people don't know. So to them, he did change time. Read on.
And laws.
And laws. Like, for example, when the day starts. God says from even to even. Whatever God says is a law. The scripture cannot be broken. But the white man come behind him, he say, no, I say midnight.
Right.
So you telling me that the new day begins at midnight? So it ain't even a new night, but it's a new day?
Right. Mm. And you better be asleep. You tell your kids you better be asleep when the day starts.
It makes no sense.
Better be asleep when the day starts.
It makes no sense at all. It's a new day at midnight.
Man.
The night is old. Mm. Wow.
Confusion.
You know what's heavy? Like I said earlier, he throw the poop right in your face and make sure they don't smell it. Hmm. Sis, how many legs do an octopus have?
Eight.
How many sides do the octagon have?
Eight.
Why is October the 10th month?
Record scratch.
Seven is seven, right? Eight is oct, right?
Right.
10 is des, right?
Yes.
Decimal, right?
Right.
So that lets you know, that lets you know that the 10th month is December. Mm-hmm. The 11th month is January. Mm-hmm. The 12th month is February. And now we're back to Passover, mm-hmm. when everything becomes new again in March, April. This, and like you said, he changed times. Our people are so duped. It's right in their face.
Right.
Like I've started off with, if our people ask questions, they will clearly get the answers. The Most High is revealing it to us, and our people would rather not know.
Yeah, he'll make the clock go forward, and or the clock to make the clock go back an hour. Where did they do that at?
Where's that in the Bible?
Well, right.
Because, you know, before you had that tick-tock on your wrist, you had the sundial. And last month, check, the sun ain't going back every couple of seasons.
Right.
That happened. That happened between our forefathers, where God made the sun back, the sun go back to show forth His power, dealing with a prophet. Mm-hmm. And the Most High God held still the sun as we slayed our enemies.
Right.
There's only two occurrences I can think about in the Bible where the sun was altered. But the white men do this thing every year.
Every year.
So what? He doing what? He's showing what? He's showing himself a God.
Right.
I can change time like God did. God made the sun stay still. I make the whole world set their clocks backward. Then I make the whole world set their clocks forward. Who gonna say I ain't when I am?
And the whole world do it.
Which brings us to, you know, on the subject of him changing times, though, he changed the day of worship from Saturday to Sunday.
Bring it out.
Even in Spanish, the word for Sabbath is sabado. Mm-hmm. Even in Spanish. So the all nations know what day the true Sabbath is. Mm-hmm. Read Daniel 7:25 again. I'm gonna look up some real quick, read this.
This is the book of Daniel, chapter 7, verse 25. Excuse me. And he shall speak great words against the Most High, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High,
uh-huh.
and think to change times and laws, and they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of time.
So listen, outside of New Year's, him changing the time, but that we covered that. We understand that New Year's is not the new year. midnight is not the new day. You understand? But also, he also changed the day of worship from the Sabbath to the first day of the week, which is Sunday. You get any calendar. Take it back to pre-K. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Everybody know the first day of the week is Sunday.
Right.
Pull out your iPhones and your Androids. Y'all have a cellular device party. And you will see that the first day of the week is Sunday. The last day of the week is Saturday.
Did you just say cellular device party?
A cellular device party. All right. So look, watch this. Let's look at the word Sabbath in different languages. Name the language and then name the word they got for Saturday. This is the word Saturday, so-called Saturday.
This is Arabic, Sabbat.
In Arabic, the word for Saturday or Sabbath is Sabbat. Continue.
Armenian, Shabbat.
Mm-hmm. Like in Hebrew, Shabbat Shalom. That means happy Sabbath. Go ahead.
Bosnian, Sabbata.
Mm-hmm.
Bulgarian, Sabbata.
Mm-hmm.
Corsican, Sabbata.
Mm-hmm.
Croatian, Sabbata.
Mm-hmm.
Czech, Sabbata.
So all these different languages, they realize that Saturday is the Sabbath. They keep saying Sabbath, Sabbath, Sabbath. Go ahead and continue.
Georgian, Sabbata.
Mm-hmm.
Greek, Sabbata.
Mm-hmm.
Hebrew, Shabbat.
Shabbat, come on.
Indonesian, Sabtu.
Sabbath, come on.
Italian, Sabato.
Mm-hmm.
Latin, Sabbatum.
Mm-hmm.
Maltese is Sipt. Polish, Sabato.
Mm.
Portuguese, Sabado.
Mm.
Romanian, Sambado.
Mm-hmm.
Russian, Sabato.
Wow.
Serbian, Sabato.
Sabbath.
Slavic, Sabato.
Sabbath.
Slovene, Sabato.
Sabbath.
Somali, Sabti.
Mm-hmm.
Spanish, Sabato.
Sabado.
Sudanese, Sabtu.
Mm-hmm.
Ukrainian, Sabato.
Sabota.
Wait a minute. So you mean to tell me the USA is the only country that has no correlation to what the how the Sabbath looks or sounds?
Nope,
like.
They put Saturday after Saturn, the Roman god Saturn.
Wow. Yep.
The Roman gods, and we'll come back to Saturn and Saturnalia later. We ain't forgot about Christmas.
Right.
We saving Christmas for y'all. We know y'all already won the debt.
Babylon.
And we already broke. And they already broke. Still trying to dig out that hole.
And we gonna put salt in the wound. I'm just being easy on you. I'm giving you a break.
Right.
I'm tired. I've been working hard. But I'm coming for that thing. I'm coming for old Saint Nick.
I'm coming
for old Nick. But just showing you that any calendar, even the other countries and other nationalities on the planet, they all reverence the seventh day of the week as the Sabbath from the Bible. Give me that real quick. You know what I want. And Genesis 2. Genesis 2, verse 1. But meanwhile, 95%, it may even be more than that. 95% of our people who say they fear God, who say they believe in His Bible, when they go to worship weekly, they're going on a Sunday. Mm-hmm. Even though the day of worship is the Sabbath, the seventh day of the week, which everybody recognizes in their own tongue as different variations of the word Sabbath.
All the other nations know that the Sabbath day is the seventh day, Saturday.
That is the Sabbath of the Jews. They all recognize that thing. The white man say, well, I'm going to call it Saturday, after my guy from ancient Rome, Saturn.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to bring y'all all here, and y'all go all call it Saturday.
And guess what? Now I'm going to name a planet after Saturn.
Right.
And then I'm going to have a car dealer after Saturn. give me that Genesis 2.
Genesis chapter 2, verse 1.
The devil.
Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them.
Mm-hmm.
And on the seventh day, God ended his work, which he had made,
mm-hmm.
and he rested on the seventh day.
So God rested on the seventh day, come on.
From all his work which he had made.
Mm-hmm.
And God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it.
He sanctified it, he made it clean. Read on.
Because that in it he had rested from all his work which God created and made.
You see that thing? So now get Exodus 20, just to show y'all what goes along with that. So the Sabbath is actually the first holy day in the Bible. You know, it's not Passover, it's not the Feast of Tabernacles, it's not Pentecost. The very first holy day that is mentioned in the Bible that was sanctified is the seventh day Sabbath. So get there real quick.
Exodus chapter 20, verse 8.
Mm-hmm.
Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
Mm-hmm.
6 days shalt thou labor and to do all thy work,
mm-hmm.
but the seventh day is of is the Sabbath day of the Lord thy God.
Uh-huh.
In it thou shalt not do any work,
uh-huh,
thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy maid, thy manservant, uh-huh, nor thy maidservant, nor thy cattle, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates.
So God gave us that day as a day of rest. He only want our animals working. That's how important that day is. No one works on that day. Not even your slave working on that day. But guess what? This place have changed times in God's laws. Y'all see that thing? So not only did he change the calendar, when the season starts, when the day starts, but he's also changed the day of worship. So guess why people are worshiping God wrong? But they say they love God. They never have learned how to love God. So real quick, let's get fossilized customs, because speaking of Sunday and how over 90%, I'm gonna say 97%. It might be closer to 99% because there's so many so-called Christians in the world. It's billions of them. Last time I checked, I think it was like almost over 2 billion Christians. One third of the Earth's population is Christian. So, and I want to say almost all of them worship on Sunday. Mm-hmm. Almost all of them. So he's not only changed the day of worship from Saturday to Sunday. Now you factor in Easter Sunday, aka Church's America's Top Model.
Oh yeah.
You know, you got the baby blue three-piece suit with the blue powder hat with the feather on it.
Probably pull out that zoot suit.
I'm about to kill him.
You had to lay out the day before with the Stacey Adams on the floor. I'm about to kill him. You was rubbing your hand. I'm about to kill him. You was in your room doing the George Jefferson. I'm about to kill him in the morning.
Right.
I'm about to kill him in the morning.
You know, moon doggy.
Heads turning tomorrow, boy.
Mama got that candy red, candy pink dress. The skirt to stop at the knee.
Yeah.
That thing like a rectangle.
That Cleveland's Cut 2000.
With them stockings on, they not fishnets though. And she classy. Got the candy red pink on. Candy red, candy pink.
Pastor gonna sit her right in front of the church.
Big mama got the big hat. That thing like a flying saucer landed on her head.
Got an aquarium on that thing.
it like an exhibit pimp that thing. You got every Easter Sunday, you got Ebenezer Baptist Church Top Model. That thing was crazy. Dapped and dressed. You got painted eggs all over the place. Nobody ever stopped and said, what do a egg and a bunny got to do with our Lord and Savior?
Man.
Land of his life, but they just in the Calvary.
All the
Calvary.
Way.
All and the way. Let a child ask. He'll get cussed out by his mama or his grandma. But go somewhere and sit down. Sat down somewhere.
I was traumatized. He got cursed. Some truth just came out.
What does an Easter egg and Christ have to do with each other? Hey, go somewhere.
No wonder his brother never smiles. You know, I didn't get cursed out for that thing.
But boy, just get a piece of ham and be quiet.
Defile yourself and be quiet.
Every Easter, you gotta have the ham with the cuts in it, with the toothpicks, with the pineapples,
yeah,
with the glaze.
With the
glaze. And the glaze falls into the cuts.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Man.
He remembered that thing right there, bro.
Man. Hey, for real.
That smell was, that was a spirit on that thing.
Hey, don't put the ham on my plate until you dip it in the glaze at the bottom of the pan.
Yeah, with
or
the
take a spoon and drizzle it over the ham.
You only dip one side. You cut somebody for dipping one side.
I want the pineapple, mama.
You dip both sides. It's nutritious. It's a great way to stay in shape.
Man. No, but, all right. We vex somebody on the air. Yeah.
Hey, most of God says swine is of the devil. That's an unclean animal.
That's right.
We are not to eat that thing.
Period.
All right. So look, let's get Fossilized Customs by Lou White. Got the book. Let's get page 12. Just read the highlights on page 12. Fossilized. It's the blue cover.
And what's so heavy?
What's under your keys, sir?
We talking about that ham. We eat an abominable food, reveling.
Page 12.
All manners of wickedness on these days. It's like we set up to put ourselves in deep sin, and no matter what, our people love that thing. They love it. Even that those who's listening today, after they hear this, they still looking forward to Christmas and the next holiday. That just shows you how sleep our people is and how much they really dislike God.
Mm-hmm. You got that page 12?
Page 12, yes.
Yeah, read on the highlighted parts.
This is from the book Fossilized Customs.
Fossilized Customs, old customs.
Old.
The Pagan Origins of Popular Customs. Mm-hmm. Page 12. Easter was already one of the two biggest celebrations observed by pagans.
Uh-huh.
Long before Christianity came along.
Whoa. You're not going to tell my grandmama. That Easter ain't synonymous with Christ and his resurrection.
Right.
That's what my grandmama told me. So you're going to have to do that thing again for my grandmama who's listening. Go ahead, bro.
Easter was already one of the two biggest celebrations observed by pagans.
Listen good, grandmama.
Long before Christianity came along.
Before mm-hmm. Christ was even born, they kept Easter Sunday.
Now say amen.
Before Joseph was born, his daddy, before Mary was born, wow. They kept Easter Sunday. Read on.
The impregnated by the sun.
Read that whole thing.
Oh, the whole thing. Okay.
Huh?
Easter was already one of the two biggest celebrations observed by pagans, long before Christianity came along. It is my belief that when it was exposed, it will fulfill the prophecies of Revelation 18.
Mm-hmm. Now read the next highlight part.
They engage in ritual sex acts.
Hold on. I thought on Easter it's about the Lord's resurrection. His his death, burial, and resurrection, the triple entendre. I thought that's what it was about. You mean to tell me it's not about that?
That zoot suit ain't for nothing.
Damn.
That spirit's still in them.
Go ahead, read that.
Damn.
Let me read it from the top of the It says, this festival involved the rites of spring near the equinox of Venus.
Near the equinox, which is right before the spring starts. You have the vernal equinox. Go ahead.
When pagans believed the earth mother was impregnated by the sun,
mm-hmm.
They engage in ritual sex acts.
So this is earth worship, and this is orgies and fertility worship. Go ahead.
And use symbols of fertility, like eggs, rabbits.
Why? Because eggs symbolize what? Ovaries, sperm. Mm-hmm. So everything that you're doing is ritualistic. So you got the kids painting eggs, and those eggs symbolize
ovaries.
Ovaries hold semen. This is all sick.
Sick.
It's sick stuff.
Same time the animals mate. It's animalism.
Oh man.
It's all animals.
Mating season.
Right. Same thing.
Bird calls.
Man, that spirit is
gorillas, bushes shaker. That's crazy. Mating season. Go ahead.
Damn.
And use symbols of fertility like eggs, rabbits, and hot cross buns.
What they say? They humping like what?
Rabbits.
Humping like rabbits. You were trying to tell? You sit in church like, what's up with these? They done bought the rabbit suit. Don't tell me that they ain't bought a rabbit suit at y'all church.
Right.
They bought that.
She waiting for it now. It's hanging in her closet.
They bought that. They bought that baby blue rabbit suit with the white belly. It reminds you of Thumper. You like, that's what Thumper.
Passing out Cadbury eggs. Yeah. That's crazy.
So, what? Now, it all go back to what? Fertility, sex, orgies, old sacrifices and rituals, way before Christ was ever born. That's why we opened up earlier about questions. Question is the ability to organize your thinking. What are these colorful eggs have to do with the Lord, the black Messiah, Jesus Christ, getting slaughtered by some Roman white boys? There ain't nothing pretty about that thing.
No.
What do a bunny, a hopping bunny, a freaky little bunny that want to hump and have, bunnies multiply quick. What do they have to do with the Bible? What scripture is that, Pastor?
Right after they call Friday Good Friday, after our king get killed, crucified, beat, and then they call that Good Friday and celebrate this a couple days later.
That's not a fish fry.
Everybody eat fish that day.
But our people, they won't ask these questions. Why? Because they're comfortable in these traditions. Right. They don't want to change.
It's fun to them.
They're not going
to
ask these questions. Like, why do we do these things?
Question is the ability to organize your thinking to find out what you do not know. But people don't care. They don't care. Remember we read earlier, Psalms 82 and 5. They said they know not. Neither would they understand. They just walk in darkness. They're like, oh, it's bright in here. There ain't not a light on in the room. It's wonderful in here. I think the darkness is great for the drapes.
That's why they wear shades in the club.
Oh,
my
God.
That thing darked out, man.
Wow.
Stay asleep.
Finish that, bro. Go ahead.
I'm gonna keep reading, or?
Yeah. Right. Read that next highlight part. Should be three highlights.
To ensure a To ensure a prosperous growing season.
To ensure a prosperous growing season. Go ahead.
Pagans rolled eggs decorated with bright colors.
They did what?
Pagans rolled eggs decorated with bright colors of spring on their fields.
Mm-hmm. Damn.
Hoping to imbue fertility.
So hoping to what? Bring forth fertility.
Mm. But it's for the kids.
I just do it for the kids.
It's for the kids.
That's why I got the Easter basket.
Damn.
And you wonder why little Raheem, something wrong with him. Case, something strange.
Case in hell, what? Somebody done slipped something in his Easter basket. Go ahead.
These eggs were then hidden from evil spirits.
Hold on. Mm. And what they got today? They got what?
Easter egg hunts.
They got the Easter egg hunt.
But it's for the kids.
Way before Christ.
Putting all types of demons on your children.
Way before Christ, they was what? Hiding the eggs. They was hiding eggs. Demon got to come find them. Is it more than that?
These eggs were then hidden from evil spirits in rabbit's nest. Mm-hmm. Another symbol of fertility.
You said the thing, they would hide the Easter egg in a rabbit's nest. So you got double fertility. They're like, yeah, all the women getting pregnant this season.
Man.
Easter is the name of the Babylonian mother of harlots.
Uh-huh.
Revelation 17.
So from there, go to the other book. The Antichrist. Go to that one. Page 44.
And that's why they call this place Babylon the Great. We're pulling out all these different gods and goddesses that our people celebrate consistently throughout the year. All manners of wickedness. That's why this place is sufficient to burn, man. Turn their backs on the Most High God.
This is from the book, The Antichrist 666.
Mm-hmm. Start at page 44.
Page 44.
And you're going to stop at the top of 45. Stop at Nineveh.
This Sunday was the holiest of holy to the pagan.
It says, this Easter Sunday was the holiest of holies for all the pagans. Meaning what? Those who don't worship the one true God of this Bible. If you don't worship the God of this Bible, you are a pagan. You got false gods and idols that you deal with. You deal with demons.
Period.
Go ahead.
This pagan observance was called Easter. Mm-hmm. And on this special day, the flowers of the gods would hold what modern Christian churches call today sunrise services.
And do they call it sunrise service?
Early.
You want a sunrise service, girl?
Yeah. Mm. You got your money?
I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Wow.
We got a guest. We got a guest. A guest preacher
with the green suit.
Go ahead.
The same New Year festival that was held in Mesopotamia was also held in Western Asia and Greece under the name of Adonis. Mm-hmm. He too was mourned with bitter wailing, and the East Star was his symbol. Mm-hmm. Has the reader ever wondered what the Easter Bunny has to do with the resurrection of Christ?
Bring it out.
Or the Easter egg? Like the festival of Christmas and the Christmas tree, they have nothing whatsoever to do with the gospel of Christ.
Shots fired.
Boom.
Oh, man.
Reload.
We need bombs.
Reload.
The Queen of Heaven was also a goddess of fertility. Mm-hmm. And because the rabbit and the hen were noted for their many offspring, they were her symbols. Mm. Even the word Easter is of pagan origin.
Even the word itself is evil. The word Easter itself is evil. Uh-huh. Go ahead.
But our people be like, Happy Easter.
And I'd be like, enjoy your holiday. I'm in work right now. I would tell you, I'd be at work boiling. That everybody, happy. Enjoy your holiday. Enjoy your holiday.
Right.
I'm like, what are you doing today? You see him at work, right? Oh, yeah, I noticed that, yeah. Are you getting time of that? No, base pay.
Israel getting real mean at this time of the year. Like,
base pay.
Enjoy your holiday.
Base pay. All right, well, you have a great day. I always have a great day. How you doing? Any better? I couldn't stand it. I'm doing just fine. Go ahead, read that.
Even the word Easter is of pagan origin. Uh-huh. It is Chaldean and means Astarte. Uh-huh. This is one of the titles of Beltis, the Queen of Heaven, at Nineveh.
Right, so the worship of the god Easter goes all the way back to what? Ancient Babylon, ancient Nineveh. Quite crazy, all those who put us into captivity. The ancient, right. the ancient Babylonians put the Israelites in captivity right. under mm-hmm. Nebuchadnezzar. Mm-hmm. We serve, we fought against, the southern kingdom fought against, well, Christ fought for us against the Assyrians, mm-hmm. Salmaneser. And then he also put northern kingdom, the 10 tribes, in slavery. Took them up, out the land and put them in slavery and put heathens in their land. Mm-hmm. That was under Assyria. The capital of Assyria was Nineveh.
Right.
And they were slaughtering our people, the 10 tribes. They was hanging their bodies, leaving, and wouldn't even bury them. Leaving their bodies out in the street. You can read that history in the Apocrypha in the book of Tobit as well. Mm. So it goes all the way back to the same ones who enslaved us and oppressed us.
Do you know what's heavy? If our people could really see, like we started off on 4th of July, if we see the scrutiny our people is going through on that day, the Thanksgiving, the origin of all that, all these holidays come with the slaughtering of our people. And yet when you tell them that's not of our custom, they turn their back from it. But what is it showing you? That you truly are a pagan, Gentile, heathen. This is you. Until what? Until you come back to the Most High God. You still have a chance, as long as you're listening to this word right now.
You see that thing?
You have a chance to repent.
You see that thing? What is that? Give me Jeremiah 17. You know how people gonna say, well. You know how people start, you know, when people get the understanding and the correction from the Bible, you know, they turn back into a slave, right? They're like, well, God knows my heart. Why do you get the trembling spirit from slavery all over again?
Sure.
Well, God knows my heart. I'm going to keep on doing what I've been doing, brother.
You know you're worthy of death.
Give me Jeremiah 17, verse 9.
They also say, I don't do it for those reasons. I do it, you know, just for family gathering.
Family.
For the family.
For the family.
I don't do it because all
it's
that pain.
It's always excuse.
Okay, well, I got a precept from God Bible for both of those rebuttals, okay? Start off with Jeremiah 17 and verse 9.
Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 9. Mm. The heart is deceitful.
No. God knows my heart is true.
The heart is deceitful.
No. That's your heart, brother. That's not my heart, brother. Read that again.
No. The heart is deceitful above all things.
Above all things you can imagine. Read on.
And desperately wicked.
Your mind is searching for excuses not to repent.
Who can know it?
God said, who can? This is God out of his own mouth telling Jeremiah, look, I don't deal with that. I know your heart stuff. The most I look into a man's heart, he says, look, this thing is all over the place. This thing is doing cartwheels. Mm-hmm. One minute you love me, one minute you don't. You stub your toe, you curse me out.
Right.
God said, the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? This is the most I'm saying, who can know it? Mm. What do God do in the heart? Go ahead, read on.
Verse 10. I, the Lord, search the heart.
He says, I'm all through that thing. Read on.
I try the reins.
I'm looking at your intentions. I'm looking at your ulterior motives. I'm looking at your laziness. I'm looking at your excuses.
Right.
I'm all through that thing. You heard what to do. And then inside of you, what? You rebuttal with your excuse. Read on.
Even to give every man according to his ways.
You see that thing? He says, whenever you get done with your excuses, I'm going to judge according to your ways and how it didn't line up with this. But what didn't line it up with this?
Right.
Then Uriah, he said what? He said, they say what, Uriah, what you say?
Yeah, I would say, well, I don't celebrate it for those pagan reasons. I do it to, you know, be with family, to gather my family and, you know, just have a good time.
Oh, Job 14.
Real quick, for those who don't know, let them know what heart is, because a lot of people get that feeling in their heart, but they don't even know what that thing is.
Which so, one? Bring it off, which one?
You get the get 721.
I'm already there. Are you already? Okay,
all right. He's already on. Mark 7, chapter 7, verse 21.
Come on.
From within, out of the heart of men.
So this is out of the heart of men, because everybody feel good in their heart, but what is the heart? Just like we don't know what our nationality is, or we don't know what time it is, we don't even know what the heart is when we say it. We don't know what we're saying when we're saying these things. So God clarifies that thing for us. What is the heart? Read that again.
For from within, out of the heart of men, proceed evil thoughts.
So what is the heart? Do your heart, the vessel that pumps blood inside of you, does that proceed evil thoughts? No. When people say, God knows my heart, he's talking about, yes, he knows what's in your mind. He knows all those wicked thoughts and all those, the lying that you're doing to yourself. No, that ain't me. Or you're making an excuse that God's word isn't applying or regarding you. That's your own evil thoughts lying to yourself. So the heart, which I've just brought out, when it says the heart, that's going into your thoughts, into a man's heart. Who could find one? It's wickedness. Everybody's heart is full of evil. Your mind is full of evil thoughts. So we have to be mindful that God knows what you're thinking and what you're doing. So again, you have to make that decision. You either repent or you die.
Right. So, so now going back to what Officer Wright brought up, saying, I just do it for the children. Okay. So, okay, let's see what God says about that. Get Job 14, because you learned today that it's wicked. You learned today that it has nothing to do with this Bible.
Right.
It has nothing to do with Christ. That a lot of these things predate Christ's mm-hmm. birth, his parents' birth, they grandparents. These things go way back hundreds of years before the Lord, before the Black Messiah. Mm-hmm. Then you sit back and say, well, I'm going to keep on doing what I've been. Okay, fine.
Go ahead.
You got to talk like you're eating my boss. Fine.
All right.
Get Job 14, verse 4.
Have at it.
Job 14, verse 4.
Good day.
Who can bring a clean thing?
Whoa. You got to read that thing slow. What did it say? What did God say?
Who can bring a clean thing?
Who can make something clean? Who can cleanse something? Make something holy, read.
Out of an unclean.
Who can take something that's evil in origin and you think you're going to baptize it?
Right.
You're going to take an orgy and turn it into a kid's fest. You're sick.
Right.
You're a sick person.
Exactly what it is.
What's wrong with you?
That's exactly what it is.
That was a good verse, because not only do they say to do it for the kids, they say, well, I do it in the name of Jesus now.
Oh, my goodness.
In the name of Jesus.
Blasphemy.
Hey, that's just like trunk or treat. This is like trunk or treat. You know what? Don't take candy from strangers. But
go to a stranger's house.
There's one day when you can take candy from dozens of strangers. Hundreds of strangers.
And eat the popcorn ball that the old lady
gave. You know what? They're saying that the Christian church is evil? Okay, well guess what? We still not gonna get rid of the evil day, but now come here and do it. Mm-hmm. Come, that's showing that the building itself was never God on. Give me Acts 7 real quick. I'm sorry. Hold that, bro. Get Acts 7:48. God not in them places, man. People think of that because they built something and put Mount Ebenezer, Salem, Jehovah, Adventist, God, Christ, Church, Latter-day Saint, First on the Block Church.
Little rock on the road.
That is holy all of a sudden. It's not holy.
Huh.
Read that, Acts 7:48. What kind of long the name is?
This is
the Catholic, Baptist, Pentecostal, non-denominational Church of God and Christ.
It's got to be holy.
What? This church, this man, I better grow wings when I walk in there.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 7, verse 48. Howbeit, the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands.
No, if a man build it, call it a church. God surely is there. The presence of the Lord is here. Read that thing again, bro.
Howbeit, the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands.
Just because a man built it don't mean God is there.
Just a little more.
That's all I want on that thing.
All praise.
The Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands. All right, now go back to Job 14.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Job chapter 14.
Verse 4.
Mm-hmm. Who can bring a clean thing out of the unclean?
Read. Well, God answered the question. He ain't leave it up for the baker. Somebody might get clever and say, God's talking about me. I can bring a clean thing out of unclean. No, he wasn't talking. No, read the answer to the question.
Who can bring a clean thing out of a unclean?
Who?
Not one.
God says not one of you Negroes can take a wicked orgy like Easter and turn into a day where you're giving out kids gift baskets.
Right.
Wrapped in plastic. Ain't that a choking hazard? How do kids got all that plastic on? Ain't that a choking? Who's overseeing this thing?
So when they say they doing it for Jesus, officer, why did they take the time and see what Jesus did and celebrate it in the Bible?
That's a good question.
And when Christ, it says Christ will give us what? The proper understanding, right? Wouldn't he say, look, reverence my resurrection? Did he give us any new high holy days?
None.
No way in Matthew, Mark, Luke, or John do you see Christ give us any new high holy days to worship.
Right.
The day I rise is the day y'all celebrate my resurrection. No.
He never said that. I missed the speech.
And what's crazy is they say he rose in 3 days, but you got Friday, Sunday.
Good Friday. That's Good Friday.
Sabbath.
So that's one.
Then you have Sunday, Easter.
Wow. So you got some Good Friday to what?
To Sunday. 2 days.
Wow.
That's 2 days.
So just as simple as the math is, like you said from the beginning.
Our people can't even add days.
You don't even
right.
got to ask that question. You don't question it, though.
You know what? It started at midnight.
So
when you carry the one, you got to carry the other half because it was middle. So that's what, you know, and it's a great way to stay in shape.
You got
to
add
pi. And it's still 2 days. You can't hear right.
Add the 3.14. You got to, don't forget pi, brother. You got to add pi in
exactly.
There.
Plus, it's going to be a fish fry on good fry. So with the good fish in the fry, and then put the symbol in the back of the car.
Boom. Right.
Good Friday. That's then, mad.
Yep. Great way to stay in shape.
Man.
And I know we out here laughing just to keep the humor, but really, this is a serious matter that our people are really lost. Y'all are lost in Babylonian customs, pagan traditions. We try to laugh at to keep our spirit because guess what? This topic could easily get a man with understanding angry about the way his people is in captivity and lost, and they don't want to wake up, and it becomes a sickness. We see our people sick. Mm-hmm. So this is why we out here every week to try to heal the souls. Guess why? So you can repent and come back to God's commandments. It's not a game, but we're going to shed light because a lot of it, It becomes humor when you can't add 3 days. You're like, wow, it's only 3 days. You know it's 2 days away. So it is funny from the naked eye that our people really that shot out. But in reality, the situation is our people are really sick. And the fact is, they're content with it. It's like walking pneumonia. You don't even know you got it, but you're sick as hell.
That's heavy. So real quick, back to that subject about, for example, the truth is coming out right now, right? You have the line being drawn. Our people have to choose what side they want to stand on. You understand? The line is being drawn. But I'm going to show you something that Christ said, because Christ already know how our people is. Christ know a Jew. Give me John chapter 3, and I ain't reading verse 16. Sorry, not reading verse 16. We know y'all can quote it. That's the only thing you can quote. Let's read John 3. And let's start at verse 16. I'm gonna show you something else right in John. Now, I know you hit this part with the black highlighter. They call it a Sharpie.
John.
Let's read John chapter 3 and start at verse 18. Watch this.
John chapter 3, verse 18.
Watch this.
He that believeth on him is not condemned.
If you believe what's coming out of this Bible right now, it says you are not condemned. We bring out the true understanding. Christ said the truth shall make you free. If you believe, you are not condemned. Go ahead.
But he that believeth not
but
is...
But bring these things out, we're showing you that your ways, which is America's ways, NASA's ways,
right.
We're showing those things are evil, and God gave us high holy days. God gave us the Passover, tabernacles, etc. God gave us the Sabbath. So we're showing you God's ways. If you believe, it says what?
But he that believeth not is condemned already.
But if you don't want to follow these things, it says even though you're alive right now, even though oxygen is still flowing and blood is still flowing through your body, it says you are already condemned. Even before you stand before the judgment. It says you're condemned already. Go ahead.
Because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God.
So watch this, verse 19.
Verse 19. And this is the condemnation.
Because we don't come on this show to condemn anybody. We come on the show to edify our people. And Lord, will we pull y'all out of the darkness. But Christ already said something very, very heavy. He said, this is the condemnation. We're not coming here to condemn you. If you live in those ways, guess what? We did too. That's why we can laugh and relate, because that was us.
All right.
So he said, but this right here, this is the condemnation. What?
That light is coming to the world. The
condemnation is that we have come into the world, and bring forth the proper understanding. Christ have given us leaders that gave us the proper understanding. Now what are we doing? We are doing, we're giving y'all the same thing that our leaders gave us in the spirit of Christ. So it says the condemnation comes when light has come into the world. Read.
And men love darkness.
That's the problem right there.
That's it.
Is when you prefer your orgy holidays.
Right.
When you prefer your holidays to go back to fertility worship instead of God worship. Right. When you prefer your Sunday over what? The Sabbath when God rested. The first holy day mentioned in the Bible. Read on.
Rather than light.
It says men prefer darkness rather than light. That's the condemnation. Read on.
Because their deeds were evil.
You see that thing? It says because their deeds were evil. They know what they're doing these days. And they don't want to make the choice to what? Live and work for God. So that's a condemnation. We are to edify people. And guess what? We was you. You understand? But the only time you can be condemned is when you prefer your wickedness.
yeah. I never back no retreat, nah. Always surviving the heat, yeah. You shoot me down in the street, hold up. I came with many, we deep, yeah. 144 deep, deep. Man, I done came with a fleet, fleet. Got all my brothers with me, yeah. I know you smelling defeat, I know you smelling defeat. You gon' be kissing my feet, yeah. All of my brothers gon' eat, eat. All of my brothers elite, yeah. Yeah, I be facing the east. Wisdom and knowledge increase. Yeah. You got a minute and seconds. God is releasing the beast. Yeah. Your time is up on a lease. I just pull up for the rent. Give me that. Don't be expecting no grace. Nah. You get no chance to repent. Yeah. My haters looking so bent. Bent. They see me flexing my strength. Flex. We came from nothing to something. Something. Now I'm 100%. Yeah. Profits you cannot prevent. Nah. They making many attempts. Nah. We gon' leave more than a dent. You do not know the extent. You are just not in my league. I don't care what you believe. Nah. Don't let the devil deceive. Yeah. Me winning is what I perceive. Yeah. Victory, I do my dance. Dance. Enemies don't get a chance. Chance. Superior, I'm too advanced. I'm way up, you looking like ants. Ants. Failure is not in my plans. Plans. Enemies don't get a chance. Chance. Superior, I'm too advanced. Yeah. I'm way up, you looking like ants. Ants. I know you smelling defeat. You gon' be kissing my feet. All of my brothers gon' eat. All of my
12.
I know you smelling defeat. You gon' be kissing my feet.
Right.
All of my brothers gon' eat. All of my brothers gon' eat.
Right. Not bombs. Not swords, not might, not force. This fight, not mine, not yours. My lord, fire finna work like July 4th. I'ma have lockjaw when it pop up. Wisdom of Solomon 5-1, like that's what I thought. We getting down to the wire, that's a nail biter. I'm a Harlem Hellfighter, dipped in hellfire. Touch my mind, knowing it till the time appointed. And even then, do it gently or it's my condolence. My slave owners went from 5A to Gamma to the third stanza of the Star Spangled Banner. And made statues stand tall like they all royal. All I'm seeing is a charbroil gargoyle. How y'all got the art of war and it's off at night? The national anthem sound like a toilet flusher. And my enemy blood gushing from bone rushing. French kids kicking death, Tim's tongue touching. In World War III, that's another joke. Seen the king decked in green, dipped in thunderbolts. With the words of the law that the brother spoke. One none left there but a puff smoke.
I know you smelling defeat. You gon' be kissing my feet. All of my brothers gon' eat. All of my
12.
I know you smelling defeat. You gon' be kissing my feet. All of my brothers gon' eat. All of my brothers.
Let me start on my lines by saying I apologize. Pushing my fall every day, B. We gon' hold the line. Who'd have thought that these seeds would be so divine? Purging out the thorny kind who call themselves upright. Well, I'ma just call them Pinocchios. Lord knows he's lying, don't kid yourself. We the only ones you look at still on the block with no pushback and crushing doctors with book bags. Counterattack. Your balancing act actually looks bad, please. I can't believe that y'all down to combat for foot tags. We need every day, all year, not just sometimes. No waking up to the new moon to fall asleep to the sunrise and hocus pocus to young minds. But what I did learn is most Judas's tend to run out of juice. Your fruits will get sun-dried, a detriment. We haven't been on excellence. And attribute all your efforts to decadence. All your pessimism to pestilence. You sick and embarrassing. You will be made irrelevant. So we won't give you no hand claps
for the ones who fall before the last hour. Who entrusted with the watchman tower. Abandoned the garrison, didn't consider their power. Who void of foresight and lack visual prowess. Students trying to get more sight. Prudence, temperance, knowledge. Who saw the bigger picture but still managed to crop it. They meddle with their sins and they pushing much anecdotes. The adventure getting grim, got more poisons than antidotes. Man, kids like them were trying to catch the rhythm. Algorithm been laid out. You rebel witches is played out. Offended little ones, now you drowning within the sea bounds. Whole world is gonna see now, huh? You gonna see now. You seem free now. You're dwelling in the pit, shaking boots, you on the fridge. You better learn to keep your wits and hold the line in this blitz. We gonna see though if you pushing for the 12 or is you pushing for the ego.
You're not a threat, you just a hopping step from a Baphomet. Chucking up the deuces to pop a squat, this is not your rest. The whole world watching, it's not a test. We broadcast from the four corners, can't stop the quest. We making haste now, chase, we don't chase down. The wicked ones flee when them feathers flutter to fake out. Ridiculous rhetoric like it's better to flake now. Or under the guise that they bucking up at a breakdown.
And they make it seem like guile's an honorable trait now. And got us wondering how they used to be on blocks pushing doctrine out. You avoiding lines like it's hopscotch in a melting pot. When that fire came, you managed to stop, drop, and tumble out. On all that matters, you cast actually acrobats. How you managed to bounce back was backbiting, turn actors. A below average attempt to stifle the acts of the Baptist. When you fight against God, all that awaits you is caskets. Bastards.
Came against our people. Even during this time period, what? They were worshiping Easter, the Queen Mother of Heaven. Again, Jeremiah 7:18.
Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 18. And the children gather wood, and the fathers kindle the fire.
The fathers getting that stove burning. Go ahead.
And the women knead their dough.
The women in the kitchen, they cooking, gossiping. Go ahead.
To make cakes to their queen, to make cakes to the Queen of Heaven.
Easter, cool. She is the Queen of Heaven. It has nothing to do with Christ. Mind you, we in the Old Testament. Jeremiah is before Christ was born. We in the Old Testament. Who are they worshiping? Some of our forefathers was going off. They was rebellious. They didn't want to follow God. So they what? They followed the gods of the heathen. The white man, he's recycling the gods of the people who ruled before him. The white man need a tardy slip. He's the last one to rule this earth, y'all. He's the last one to rule. The Egyptians have ruled already. The Babylonians have ruled twice. Once under Nimrod in the first kingdom mentioned in the Bible. Then they ruled again after Assyria. You understand? Then the Persians and Medes ruled. You know, Red Dot, they got the 7-Elevens. They ruled his earth. What was the white man that he was in a cave somewhere? Mm-hmm. And then he rose up, what, after them as the Greek Empire.
I don't know.
This man need a tardy slip. He acting like he's the forefather of civilization. Brother, civilize yourself.
Right.
That's what you need to do. Stop eating red meat. You ain't learned that thing killing you yet.
Right. He still ain't learned how to cook that thing.
You know, eat up.
He's still putting raisins in everything.
Racist.
Somebody needs to stop him.
I didn't put raisins in everything.
I don't know. You know what will make potato salad better?
Raisins.
Yeah. Who raised you? No, but read Jeremiah 7 verse 18 again. So, because what I'm showing you is that all the white man does, all his holidays are nothing but recitations or recycles of the old gods before him. You know what? It's a precept for that. Now hold what you got, and then get Psalm 64 real quick. It's a precept for that. It is a culture vulture.
Just real quick, if y'all have any questions you want to call in, The number is 216-939-5087. I know a lot of y'all scratching y'all head as y'all putting up your Christmas trees at home and still eating leftovers from Thanksgiving. This is the time to call. Save your own soul.
You throw that plate away.
Right.
It's defiled.
Them chitlins.
Three done. Oh, my goodness.
He's
eating the butt like groceries.
I'm going to go all the way in there.
Literally.
Oh, God.
Damn.
Get Psalm 64.
Put extra red hot on that thing.
Oh, my goodness. Get Psalm 64, verse 5. I hope that thing come with a side of Listerine. Psalm 64, verse 5. Go ahead.
The book of Psalms, chapter 64, verse 5.
So, what we going here? Because we showing that what? These same customs and so-called holidays that Americans celebrate, which they really hella days, they are nothing but recycled old gods from the kingdoms that rule before him. He's the last one to rule. Y'all know the white man has no creativity. He has no rhythm. He can't dance. He wears toupees. No, I'm seriously. The man has no creativity. He is not somebody who creates. All he does is duplicate. You understand? Imitation is the best form of flattery. That's why you got an obelisk in Washington. What is an obelisk from ancient Egypt doing on the back of your dollar? What is it doing in Washington? Why is it appear? Because he has no creativity. He just recycles from the old kingdoms.
The agent.
Exactly. The all matrix. Me too. So all he does, he carries all the hot, and then he just puts his stamp on them and puts a white face on it, you know. But go ahead and read that. The Bible told you that. Go ahead.
The book of Psalms, chapter 64, verse 5. Mm-hmm. They encourage themselves in an evil manner.
Yeah, like let's turn the orgy to a kid celebration. We have an aircon. Go ahead.
They commune on laying snares. Privily.
Let's tell them that it's actually about Jesus Christ. By them doing that, they did what? They set a trap. Mm-hmm. Because in order to make the mouse go to the trap, you at least got to put something in that he won't.
Right.
We have a natural desire to go towards Christ. But then they do what? They put a white face on him. You still want him?
Mm-hmm.
Then they do what? They give you the wrong holiday. You still want him?
Right.
They lay snares privately.
Damn.
They know we have the spirit in us gravitates to the Lord. So they say, okay, well, I know we know they're coming for him.
Mm-hmm.
Let's take their nationality from him. So now they can't identify with him. You understand? All these things. So read that part again. That thing is heavy.
They encourage themselves in an evil manner.
Mm-hmm.
They commune of laying snares privily.
They sit down at long tables and they what? They lay traps for our people. They keep us blind. Go ahead.
They say, who shall see them?
Who know about that they didn't keep this back before the slave ships? Who knows that this festival don't have nothing to do with us? We borrowed it from the Babylonians. They borrowed it from the Egyptians. They borrowed it from the ancient Babylonians under Nimrod. Who knows these things? Nobody knows these things. The Negro, you want to hide some from him? Just, you know where to put it at.
Mm-hmm.
No, it ain't my plain sight. It's my in the book.
Mm-hmm.
Put it in the book. He ain't going to read.
He ain't going to read it.
What these brothers doing books?
He ain't going to crack it open.
Read on.
They search out iniquities.
You see what it said? They search out iniquity. All these festivals, they old festivals. Way before the white man was even ruling. They search out iniquity. Read.
They accomplished a diligent search.
They got things from ancient Egypt, thousands of years ago, current to this day in America. Go ahead.
Both the inward thought of every one of them.
Every last one of them. Read.
And the heart is deep.
The mind of them is deep.
Damn, that's heavy.
It says the way they think, they thought process, ain't the Negro thought process.
Mm-hmm.
I'll give you an example. We go out to we hit the streets, we're going to teach our people where they are, what they must do. We're like, hey, my brother, mm-hmm. I love you, bro. Christ is a black man. He is not a white man, bro. Christ right. is a black man. The Negro, you know what the Negro says? Mm-hmm. Color don't matter.
Guess it's all color.
But guess what? When I told him that Christ was black, his mind went into thinking mode, brain blast, right?
Mm-hmm.
What came out of his mouth was, color don't matter. Meanwhile, if his color didn't matter, why they keep putting it up as a white man?
Right.
Why they keep making movies? Right. Passion of Christ, Mary right. Mother Jesus, the Carpenter's Son, over and over and over again. Mm-hmm. All the kids' movies, cartoons, animations, illustrations, everywhere. If it didn't matter, why are they spending billions of dollars to keep you seeing that same image?
Right.
Watch this though. Remember it says, our enemy, the inward thought is deep. We at camp, we teaching our people, here come the white man. He's curious. They're intuitive. Hey, hi. You gonna get fake with you?
Yeah.
Sometimes they get fake with you too fast. You get fake back. They're like, hi. You're like, hi. Where that voice come from? you get fake back with them. You know, you gotta catch yourself. Like, yeah, how you doing, sir? What are you guys teaching? Well, we teach the truth to our people, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, not you, sir, but so-called blacks, Hispanics, that the Israelites, the Bible speaks of. We must repent, come back to God's laws. Oh, I see you got an image right here. Yes, that's the true image of Jesus Christ. He's a black man according to the Bible. Immediately, you know what that brain does? I'm going to slavery. Mm-hmm. They skip past all the okay, because I'm going to slow their brain down, because that's how fast their brain move. I'm going to slow it down. We say, Jesus is a black man. They're like, black man. They mind go, Jesus is a black man. Jesus was a Jew. Jews are God's chosen people. They descended from Abraham, Isaac. God made a covenant with Abraham. He says, curse be they that curse me. And we put them into slavery. My people are going into slavery. When Christ makes his second coming.
It says the heart is deep. They think
that's how they mind move.
That's right.
That's why we say Christ is a black man. They turn red, walk away.
Yep. They don't dispute it. They don't argue. They'll never be the same.
They will never be the same.
Our people fight that thing. They take it in, like you said. They'll process that thing and just walk away. Because they know it's no arguing. Most of them already know. They just like, damn, the jig is up. jig is up.
Bro, the information is like going through a juicer.
It was
they extracting everything out of that thing. Amino acid, bro, you say Christ is black? I'm going into slavery. Immediately, Christ is coming back. I'm going into slavery. Okay, cool.
That was the same reaction, this one, it was a so-called Caucasian dude at the rec center that we do. And, you know, after listening to us break down the teachings to the blacks, Hispanics that were coming into the rec, he quietly went up to the table and said, you know what? You guys are right. And then he just walked off.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, you guys are teaching the right stuff.
Mm.
And just walked off.
He probably hit that door, that breeze hit him. He probably like, I'm going to take the long way home.
Right. But the coon that was working with him looked at him like, why are you acknowledging these niggas?
Mm.
You know what I mean? And, you know, hopefully it sparked a thought in the brother that we were trying to teach, that even if masters say they're right, maybe I should look this stuff up. Maybe I should research this stuff.
Yeah, you know how people need master validation before they believe something.
Right.
We say they turn to master, confirm? Confirm. Okay.
Right.
Validation.
Right.
Hey, all
right,
cool.
I'm sorry. You know what's heavy? What? Read that scripture one more time. That's heavy.
Talk from verse 5?
Yeah.
Psalm chapter 64, verse 5. They encourage themselves in an evil manner. They commune on laying snares privily. They say, who shall see them? They search out iniquities. They accomplish a diligent search.
He said they search out iniquities. What is iniquity? They search out our sins. How do we make these people stay away from their God? They did a diligent search to make us stay in sin. This is why they throw that ham on the table for Easter. This is why they made a perverted holiday into something holy to us now. Everything they did a diligent search. Like Off said, they laid the snare, and they basically, just like putting a stake in front of a dog where he has to walk through an obstacle to get to that stake. That dog is gonna do whatever he could do to make it there. God is right in front of us, but yet he's put these snares in front of us, and we're so blind about the things. He's changed the time in front of us. He did everything to make us sin against our God, to the point we go to church on Sunday and that's our Sabbath now. Right in our face, but we could count to seven. You know what I'm saying? Right in our face, these things happening. They did a diligent search, and guess what? He knew exactly how to dupe us. Knew exactly how to keep us from God and keep us at the bottom just by making us sin. And our people is comfortable in that day. We're going to need a part two to this, this thing heavy.
Man.
Tis the season.
So,
man.
So, last but not least, though, you got the most notable, you got the infamous, the merry, the jolly Christmas. Oh, and it's coming up, too. Oh, my God, I know somebody's sick right now.
Our people are broke. They're in debt right now because they done cashed out all these presents for their bad children. Been acting up all year. Okay, they already broke.
Mm. You got, what you got? You got elves, cookies, and a fat man. Yep, that sounds like the Bible. Yep, that sound exactly like the Bible. I don't see no reason to open the Bible.
The man that put in double overtime, triple overtime. Then I gotta give all my credit to this jelly fat white man coming, and I don't even got a chimney.
If that ain't supremacy. Like, growing up, you sitting in your house, right next to the radiator that burned half of your skin off.
Right.
And you're trying to figure out, how is he going to get in here?
Come out of here.
We got a radiator and a space heater that keep eating up my comforter every night. Waking up your socks singed at the tips. You trying to figure out, how is he going to get in here? You looking around, you wake up sniffling. Mom, I just want to know how Santa getting in here. She knows she been working double overtime.
Right.
Tell my baby, don't you worry about that. It's magic.
Yeah.
What, you talking about blue magic? Because I ain't no crack, Mama. I know we ain't got no chimney. He comes down chimneys.
Damn. Sisters give credit to a white man, and the man sitting on the couch with his barely can stay up to watch their kids open their presents because he worked all that overtime. So he can get that money for the children in the presents for them.
Exactly. And then you got they call Santa what? Saint Nick. The Saints are the Israelites, number one. But Saint, they call him Old Nick. Give me a link on that. Let's deal with that. Saint Nick.
Bring it out.
Let's talk about Old Nick for a second. Let's look at his origin. What does that even mean?
Daddy don't even get credit for eating the cookies.
Right.
Santa ate them cookies.
White man get all credit Debo. That day.
Is he Santa or Debo?
Right. I saw Mama kissing Santa Claus. He even took your wife.
and you just let little Michael grow up knowing that his mama is a whore.
Right.
On Christmas, she kissing other men. She kissing a white man.
And daddy's my, no, son. Everything is all right, son. You just let your son grow up just tainted like that.
Come on, sing it right, Michael.
Go ahead, bring it up.
Old Nick. This is from Wikipedia. Old Nick.
Old Nick. Saint Nick. Go ahead.
A nickname for Satan.
Whoa. Because I know since I was a little kid, we've been doing a little anagram, switching the letters around. I'm like, okay, if you move the N and put the T and move the A and put the N, that's Satan all day.
All day.
Wait a minute.
Santa what, is
literally,
Satan.
When you look it up, read that thing again, bro.
Old Nick.
Mm-hmm.
A nickname for Satan.
Wow, is there more on that? That's all I want on that thing.
Nickname.
Drop the mic.
That ain't pig Latin.
Right. That ain't pig Latin right there. Now, real quick, give
him one more little thing on there.
Oh, okay, go ahead.
Say a nickname for Santa Claus. Also, Old Saint Nick.
Wow.
Old Satan.
Old Saint Nick.
Wow.
And that literally translates to Satan. So guess what? You got your kids sitting on Satan's. You gonna take your kids that you have protected from everyone their whole lives. Take them to a random place. There's a random man in the red suit. You want to put them on his lap and let them bounce around.
Red suit, red face.
Tell him what you want. He like, what you want?
So that mean the kids that's crying, screaming and kicking are in the spirit.
They can sense that spirit on them. They like, this man ain't right, mama. I'm telling you, he ain't right. So look, go to the article, the Truth and Light article.
Damn.
Let's deal with that for a second.
It's wickedness at high levels.
Tell them what you want.
That's deep, man.
'Tis the season. I hope y'all paying attention
Satan
out there.
Satan.
You are in the midst of paganism.
Second to last one.
Where they say, get out! Get out! Y'all are asleep.
He's making a list.
Checking it twice.
Go ahead, bring an article out.
Oh,
start from the top.
Yep.
This one's titled "The Truth and the Light Ministries: Saturnalia, the Real Roots of Christmas." Many Christians today believe that Christmas is a Christian holiday. The fact is that people have been celebrating Christmas long before the birth of Christ. The festivity was known as Saturnalia. Saturnalia was a festival in which the Romans commemorated the dedication of the temple of the god Saturn. As winter approached, they were losing harvest and were in need of the sun in order for their harvest to grow.
Mm-hmm.
To grow and bear fruit. Saturn was the Roman god of agriculture and harvest.
Now, jump down to the third paragraph.
The Roman pagans introduced their law December 17th through 25th as Saturnalia.
Ring.
During this period, Roman courts were closed.
Sound familiar? Sounds just like America.
They went a week for this holiday.
Yeah, go ahead.
And Roman law dictated that no one could be punished for damaging property or injuring people during this week-long celebration.
Y'all give everybody a nice run of time period. It's the same spirit from Rome. Now give me Jeremiah 10 real quick. Jeremiah 10. This thing got to come out. Jeremiah 10.
So that was a day to riot and pillage.
You can do whatever you want.
Everybody, that was like the purge, huh?
Everybody nice.
Oh, yeah.
Jeremiah 10. Because this man is being severed way before Christ.
Jeremiah 10, verse 1. Hear ye the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel. Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen.
God said, do what?
Learn not the way of the heathen.
God said, don't learn the way of the heathen. Christmas is the way of the heathen. It has nothing to do with Christ. Read on.
And be not dismayed at the signs of heaven.
And don't be dismayed at the signs of heaven. Why? Because around Christmas you have the winter solstice. You have certain things going on in the heavens. So God said, don't be dismayed. Don't be caught up in all that. Because the white man, he caught up in all that stuff. He's real big at stargazing, astrology, zodiac. God telling us, don't be caught up in all that. Just do what I say. Keep my commandments. Read on.
For the heathen are dismayed at them. For the customs of the people are vain. For one cutteth a tree out of the forest, the work of the hands of the workmen with the axe.
So what custom do somebody go to the woods and cut a tree down? Is it Valentine's Day? Is it Easter? No. So it's Christmas. Read on.
They deck it with silver and with gold.
We read in the Bible, we in the book of Jeremiah, way before Christ was born, they would take a tree out of the forest and deck it with silvers and gold.
Silver and gold.
God said, learn not the way of the heathen. This is what the heathens do, worshiping their other gods. Read on.
They fasten it with nails and with hammers, that it move not.
So they ain't dragging it into the house and leaving it there. They standing it up straight. They had to fasten it with nails and hammers. Today we got a tree stand. Today we have a tree stand. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing. Read on.
They are upright as the palm tree,
read,
but speak not.
You see that thing says, but speak not. Read on.
They must needs be born because they cannot go.
Meaning they got to be carried. B-O-R-N-E means to carry something. You got to carry it on top of the car. Then you got to carry it into the house. But then you stand this thing up like it's a god. And you deck it and you pay homage to it. Then you make the kids bow down and get their gifts from it.
Damn.
Like it's a living god. Mm. It's a ritual. You understand? It has nothing to do with Christ. We read in the book of the Bible in Jeremiah before Christ was born. He said, don't do this. This is the way. This is what the heathens do. I'm not their God. I'm your God, Israel. You see that thing?
Remember as kids, at Christmas Eve, we slept under that thing, staring at the star, looking at the lights, mouth watering, and just sleep right next to the tree as if that's your comforter.
And what if you made a mistake and knocked it over?
Oh, man. Christmas over.
You might got a whooping.
You might got hands put on you.
Oh, yeah.
Because the tree is a god.
Yeah.
You making the tree an idol.
I confess to that. I got my behind whiz out. Wow. Whooped because I hit the tree and knocked it over.
That's why you don't smile no more. Tell me.
Man, I was coming up. This is therapy.
Hey, this is healing, bro. Pound it. This is healing, bro. Finish that.
Verse 5.
Uh-huh.
They are upright as the palm tree, but speak not.
God said they speak not because he acknowledging that thing is not a god, even though you're giving it all this special treatment. Go ahead.
They must needs be born because they cannot go.
You don't have to carry a god. So most of us clowning the tree right now. Because why? Because everybody give that more attention than they do this Bible and they do him. So he clowning the tree. Read on.
Be not afraid of them.
God says, don't be afraid of them. Fear God. Fear me.
Right.
You scared of knocking a tree over, but you ain't scared to not keep my commandments. Hmm. You ain't scared to not eat their pork and not break and buy and sell on my Sabbath.
Right.
Read on.
For they cannot do evil.
God says, they can't even do evil, but meanwhile, I can judge you. I can make you blind now. I can make you fly that windshield tonight when you go 5 minutes up the road. So God says, don't be afraid of them. Fear me. So we got to do it. We got to come out of Mass's holidays and come back to this Bible. You understand? All those things have pagan origins. And we can go on and on.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. or Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.